and at Little Rapids in Carver, as I mentioned. And she was a daughter of the chief at Black Dog Village at Carver Rapids, or what we know as Carver, Minnesota. She was also a half-sister of the Mdewakanton chief at Red Wing. Later, he married Jane Fraser, or what was in Mendota, and she was often referred to as Posey. One thing, in this Indian community, they had many different wives. Just no different than Henry Sibley or Faribault. They all had Native American wives, and then they later had white wives as well. I use the word white, but European wives is probably more correct. And this is one layer upon layer of history, and one layer upon history that is yet to be explored. So I have found it interesting. I hope I didn't bore you to death. But I have become very impassioned about this, and there's so much more to share, which I could not share with you tonight, that I hope to continue with working with the Mdewakanton Sioux community and Steve Vosevka, who is a Lonsdale historian, and others. I don't see Steve Frost here this evening, but I approached Steve Frost, who has also been impassioned in regard to the Native American community and has a lot to share as well. So, any questions? Yes. Well, these first group of French Canadian fur trappers lived down on the lake, Cody Lake, and now it's kind of a little park. It was formerly the Kalina Farm, and as far as the cemetery is concerned, that was established in 1865. I read, it's part of the Lonsdale Catholic Church. That transferred over in about 1907.
Is there a church right there?
Yes. Well, I've been told two different things. Next to the cemetery on the south, and then across the road. But across the road, Lassant's family has been noted as living there. So who knows? But there was a church. But it was a log church, and it later was taken down. But as far as the cemetery is concerned, I found over 130 individuals buried in that cemetery. I don't know where they put them. I was there today, and of course, walking on that ground is very uneven, so I kept envisioning, oh, this must be a grave, or that must be a grave. And that's a lot of people for that cemetery to absorb. Yes?
Is that public property?
It's owned by the... From what I understand, I haven't researched this, but it's the Lonsdale Catholic Church.
So you're not trespassing?
Well, the only thing that I saw there, and I was just excited one day when I drove by, were two bald eagles sitting on top of the pine tree. But there's no gates. There's no indication that you're trespassing. But I'm going to try to get this. I'm going to try to get the cemetery in the National Register, because it's one layer upon layer of very important stories and history to preserve and to tell. Any other questions? Yes?
Since a lot of the early Europeans married indigenous women, would those indigenous women be buried in those same cemeteries?
Yes. Absolutely.
How did the indigenous people, did they have cemeteries, or did they just bury them?
Well, they had different ways of burial, some mounds, like in Carver, downtown Chaska, that is. There are burial mounds in the park, so they did have earth mounds. Sometimes if they couldn't quite navigate that, they put them on platforms and posts and poles, and they place them above. Now there's different reasons why they may have done that. Maybe it was different branches of this Dakota that did that as a tradition. But in the book here that I brought tonight, North Country, I purchased that in the land of the Dakota at the Next Chapter bookstore in Northville, a fantastic bookstore. The North Country is published by the University of Minnesota. The Land of the Dakota by the Minnesota Historical Society. Excellent references. They're very affordable. I also brought to Tom Kyer's book, The Eight from One Bull, which for anyone that is interested in area history, it's an invaluable document. And Tom Kyer did a wonderful job. And you can buy this by calling Jerry Kyer and his wife at their family farm, which is on the original homestead. That's where I bought a copy and sent it to a friend in the Czech Republic. This is a map showing Cody Lake and the adjoining lake. And I've indicated with little colored arrows and written some of the first settlers that lived on those sites. The Bureau of Land Management is a great place to look to find where these original claims were made. And I found it really quite informative. Any other questions?
The acoustics are not good in here at all. So could you please tell me, do you feel quite certain that log church was near Twin Lakes, Cody Lake, wherever? Or is it at all possible that it could have been across the French
Sea? Either one. I've been told two by two different people. It was next to the cemetery in the south. And then one. Well, then I was told west across the road, too. Two different places.
But the reason that came to mind, I don't know if it was there, I couldn't tell you the there was a schoolhouse on that corner, uh-huh. Exactly west.
I'm sure. Well, where the Peeper Hog Farm is located, that was the first post office, and it was right across from Lake Mataga. It was plotted as a town around that little lake, and Larry Sherrick, who also conducted a hog operation there, they lived in the log house that property was on, and that log house was. Larry Sherrick's family came from Plum Creek, and Larry Sherrick's family is Don Sherrick's family, and they started and established a post office in that spot. So, you know, with time, so many things are lost, and I'm glad you brought that up. Any other questions before I turn it over? I'm getting dry. I guess I'm in the right place, right? I'll wet my whistle. But thank you so much and for being so patient with me. And I appreciate you taking the time to come this evening.
Thanks.